Well, the Trans-Tasman travel bubble has burst, with Jacinda Ardern announcing an 8-week pause on the quarantine-free arrangement between Australia and New Zealand.
For more on this, we're joined by Air New Zealand CEO Greg Foran from Auckland and the chair of the Australian Federation of Travel Agents, Tom Mannering from Melbourne. Good morning, guys. Greg, first to you. Let's start with you. How are you feeling about this announcement?
Well, morena to both of you, and just before I say anything, I want to say kia kaha, strong for Australia, and we're close neighbours, and our hearts and thoughts go out to all of you. We've got plenty of Aussies and Kiwis on both sides, so this is a challenging time. Look, in terms of the announcement, we went into this bubble knowing that this could occur, so we're reasonably used to having to pause and start and stop, and we've been dealing with that over the last few weeks. Clearly, we'd rather be open and up and running, but that's not the case, so now we've just got to get on and deal with it.
Yeah. Jacinda Ardern has given Kiwis 1 week to return to Aotearoa. What are you doing to make sure they get home safe and sound?
Yeah, Richard, look, we geared up really quickly when we found out what was going to happen, and through, our internet and call centres, we've been able to take customers' queries and concerns. We've actually got about 4,000 seats available right now for people to get home, but that's spread across the country. Obviously, New South Wales is a bit different because of the MIQ requirement. Mm. But we have put extra flights now out of Melbourne and also Perth, and we're monitoring that literally by the hour, and we'll add in capacity as required.
Australian visitors are a huge market for you guys. How important is it there for there to be quarantine-free travel across the Tasman?
Well, clearly that's what we'd prefer to have happen, and that's what was put in place. And we were building quite nicely over the last couple of months. This bubble went into effect from the 19th of April. We were excited. Certainly parts of the country had geared up for it, in particular areas like Queenstown. Richard, I think you were down there
recently. 4 weeks ago.
Queenstown. Yeah.
Beautiful.
So how things have changed. We want to have you back. It is important. I think it's good for a whole bunch of aspects, not least tourism. I've got three children living in New South Wales who I'd love to be able to get in and see a bit more of as well. So let's hope we can get this thing through and up and running at some point.
I got a son in Whanganui. Yeah, we share it. We were promoting travel across the Tasman. It's amazing what can happen in such a short space of time. Let's bring in Tom. Tom, tough 18 months for the Australian travel industry. Just another body blow here, mate.
Yeah, I'm lucky to be happier circumstances because we're a happy industry. But last 18 months has just been a shocker. And the on-off again, as Greg was saying then, it just makes it impossible for business. And you're doing a lot of work three and four times for no earnings. Mm. So the industry really is on its knees at the moment.
Terrible. This means a flood of holiday cancellations. What does it mean for you? Are you having to lay off staff? What effect has it had?
The staff layoffs have been thousands in our industry in Australia, and we have an office in New Zealand, but for the Federation, it's just been horrific. I mean, 30% down, 15,000 jobs have been lost already, and we're down to about 25,000 out of 40. So sites around Australia, there's still 2,500-3,000 travel agents, so they're still fighting. The issue is basically with the on-off, vaccinations are the key. We want everybody to get vaccinated now so that by the end of this year they can travel in 22 and get the cash flow going and save the industry.
No JobKeeper this time around either. Business is going belly up. What needs to happen? What sort of support does the travel industry need?
That's right. I mean, we have to be looking now. We're in a worse position now than we were this time last year. We've had 18 months of no income, 95% negative. These businesses, and amazing. So they're family businesses right around Australia. 70% of our workforce are women, so we need support. We're getting some from the government, but we need it to stretch through for the rest of this year now. We're one of the few industries that's been affected from day one.
Yeah, we all see it and share your pain. Thank you both so much for coming on the show today. We appreciate it. Good luck with everything.
It's just so tough for them.
It's terrible. It's horrible.